Hi guys, welcome back to the vlog. We are starting the vlog in the secondhand furniture shop. Wasn't meant to, but I've basically found this wardrobe and I'm a little bit obsessed with it.
A little bit.
Look at the top of it, it is gorgeous. This is so beautiful, this wooden coving. It is proper wood. Look at that detail in the middle. The handles have locks on them. And then that bottom drawer, the feet, has a lock key turn. And then you pull that out. Can you see that? Inside even has a really beautiful ribbed wood effect. There's hooks on the back. That key works for both locks. I am really, 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 really a little bit obsessed. What do you think? I'm saying to Rob though, we don't really have anywhere to put it apart from the second bedroom, which is where guests would stay. Maybe we should do that and have it as a little closet for when people come to stay for a couple of nights. They can put their suitcase in there. They can hang up shirts and coats. I am obsessed with this piece.
Guys. It's mine. I'm taking it. We're gonna go pay for it now.
So I've just got to Sue Rider. You can see it in the background. If you don't know, Sue Rider is a charity shop, or it's a charity, and they have shops across the country, but there is quite a big one near me. If you live in the Peterborough area, this one is in Eye, and it is so good for furniture. Now that we've moved house as well, I'm really excited to see what they've got and maybe perhaps what I can pick up. I'm looking for a desk. I know exactly what I have in mind. I'm going to put some inspiration pictures on screen because I'm so desperate to find a desk this style. I have been searching for months, like when I say probably more than 6 months, and I have either been unfortunate and lost out, or I just cannot find this specific style in an older desk that I can upcycle myself. So I'm this close to buying one, but I really fancied upcycling it anyway. And then also I'm looking for some bedside drawers for our main bedroom, and probably soon for our second bedroom as well, because we'll likely make over that room, because today the wardrobe that you saw in the first clip is getting delivered. I think it's getting delivered this afternoon, and yeah, I'm so excited. That has given me such a boost of like excitement to actually start decorating the house now. Like, I think I was just looking for that one piece that kind of like sparked that excitement for me, and it was that. Like, I was saying to Rob in the shop, I was like, I can't let this piece go, and he was like, are you really sure you want that wardrobe? I was like, nothing has made me more excited and has like brought me this much joy in a long time, and that's saying something. So I knew that was my gut feeling, that I just had to go with it, get the wardrobe. It's gonna start this whole process for me. I know that sounds so over the top, but honestly, like, this is why I even got into DIY and all this stuff, because the little ball of fuzziness that it gives me in my tummy, like, it's just pure excitement. Anyway, so I'm gonna bring you in the shop. I'm probably gonna film on my phone because I get a little bit embarrassed with this like whole setup that I've got here, and it's quite a quiet shop and I don't want to like disturb them, but they have got some really good pieces, so let's see what we can find.
Hey, I heard you got a new best friend. Yeah, it hurts a bit, I won't pretend that it doesn't matter that you're with someone else. In a way, that's how it's supposed to be. If I'm unable to make you happy, then it's for the better that you are not with me. That's why I wrote you a letter, cause you see, I write so much better than I speak. And I need to tell you, you were my best friend till the end. I hope I'll be happy without you, but right now I don't know what to do. It's hard to get over, you chose someone else, a new best friend. Feel like it was long ago. We were head over heels in love, thought it lasts forever, but somehow we got lost. Looking back, I didn't realize what was wrong with me. I can't deny I took you for granted. You finally had enough. Right now I don't know what to do. you're with someone else. That's why I wrote you a letter. Cause you see, I write so much better than I speak. And I need to tell you, you were my best friend to the end. I hope I'll be happy without you. But right now I don't know what to do. It's hard to get over.
So they've put it in the garage, but I didn't have the nerve to tell them, like, please can you put it like back together and like face it forward. So I'm gonna have to do that now. So they've put it here. It's here, but you can't see it. I will not be able to lift this on my own. So the back of it is wood. It looks like maybe pine, but I love the back of it. Can you see this, like, it's almost like paneling. I mean, you're never going to see the back of it, but I just love the fact that it's like that. It's got these notches on top. If you can't see, they're just like square wooden blocks, and that's what holds the three pieces together. So there's this piece, which is the middle, the base is there, and then the top's there. Oh my God. I hope that they gave me the spare bit of wood. Yeah, it's in there. Almost certain that it's solid wood, even though it's like slats of wood. So even the sides, oh no, wait, maybe not. Because I can see that these are joins of wood. Okay, I think it's got a veneer on top, which I can see now. It's a very nice veneer though. So, because it's a veneer, I'm gonna have to be super careful when I sand it. So I think tomorrow what I'm gonna do is head to B&Q and get some more sandpaper and get some really high grit sandpaper. So a low grit, 40-80, that's kind of the hard stuff that if you've got like a bulk of paint that you need to get off, you want to like rip into that surface and like really sand it down, you use that. But a higher grit means a smoother finish. So I usually use like a 120 in between coats of paint on furniture, or like a 240 if you want like a really velvet smooth finish. Only other thing I think I need to consider is doing a lead test paint. A lead paint test. This is a varnish, but it is quite an older piece, so just to be careful with the sanding, because you know you don't want it to fly around, and if it's got lead in it, I'm gonna end up inhaling it. But yeah, I'm so happy that it's here. And I'm still so buzzing, like just as much as I was the other day when I saw it for the first time. I love it. I love it a lot. I love it! I'm just going to put this in front because it's quite front heavy and I don't want it to topple over. So this should keep it upright. Guys, I've had quite the afternoon of doing admin stuff. It's just so boring, but I've done so many like little ticks. I have this book, by the way, this diary. I have plenty of diaries, but I'm really enjoying this one at the moment. This is the Grace Beverly productivity method planner, and it really, really helps me plan my days out. Can you see it has different sections? So it says quick ticks. These are usually things that you can get done in under 5 minutes. Tasks, which are sometimes comprised of quick ticks, but may take you between 5 and half an hour. And then projects, which are longer term things. You might not tackle them in the day, over the next few days, but they're just there, so they're always in your mind. And these are usually comprised of larger tasks, and these can range anywhere from like half an hour to like, I don't know, for me, projects that would take me days to do. And then it's got three non-negotiable things that I'm going to do today, and they're not normally things that are quite like easily done on your tick list so that you can be like, oh well, I've done them today. They're usually things that are like, okay, now I have to get this done, I'm going to stop slacking, I'm going to get this done because it's been on my mind and I just want it out of my system. So if you put those down as your three things, you kind of feel obliged to get them done. But not to make them unrealistic, but things that are realistic but that you should get done today, that you can get done today, if that makes sense. And then we've got schedule on side, which ranges from 5 a.m. I've never seen her before, all the way through to 10 p.m. Again, I don't really tend to fill it out down here. My day on this usually ranges from 9 till about 5, so I have been trying to implement a 9 to 5, just as if I were going to go to an office. So this morning that comprised of me going to the charity shops, doing some filming for you guys, doing this vlog. I've come home, I've been doing emails for about 4 hours, a little bit of editing as well. But yeah, being able to break the day down like this really helps me foresee like where I'm going to do stuff. Otherwise, I don't know about you, but in my head I kind of get panicky about like, oh, I know I've got all these things to do, but it really like, it actually hurts my head thinking about it. And then I get a bit anxious and then I'm like, I'm not doing anything, and I literally like shut the door on it and I want to run away. Stuff like this has really helped me with that from like an anxiety point of view, because I can see what I need to do and it feels so good ticking things off. I wanted to read you this email that I've written. In the garden, it turns out that there is a small square of land, which you cannot see, but it's like over here. I will show you it one day. If you go back and watch videos of mine, you'll probably see it in the garden. But it's this small square of land that does not belong to us. So our garden is not a perfect, complete square. It kind of has this random chunk missing from it. And looking from our windows out over the top of it, there's nothing there. Like, I don't know why they built our garden like that. Leads me to believe that maybe there's a reason that we can't have it, but my aim is to try and buy that piece of land from whomever owns it. We got chatting to our neighbours across the road. They're so lovely. It is the best thing, having nice neighbours, honestly. And he was able to give me this, basically like a land registry blueprint. I'm not going to be able to show you because it's got my whole address on here, but it's a literal blueprint. The land registry for our county and district, it's got like a title number, it's got a map of the all of the plots for this estate when they were built. And because he bought some land in 2014, he had all of the contact details, so he shared them with me. I got in contact, I rang them the other week. She told me to send an email. So she said, send an email with like what it is that you want, the like where the land is, send some pictures and all that stuff. So I've come up with a little email. Inquiring about a small piece of land that I understand you may own. My address is blah, blah, blah. On the attachment, this is represented by a plot, blah, blah, blah. I'm looking to purchase the land, estimated 4 meters by 2 meters, to make my garden a whole square. I mean, they don't really need to know that. Should I take that out? I don't know. On attachment, blah, blah, blah. This is represented by the letter F on plot, blah, blah, blah. Purchasing this will allow me to start garden plans this summer. Please, can you help with this inquiry? I have attached a further 2 images of the garden and the land that I'm referring to. I mean, I'm not like the best at writing really professional emails, but I feel like that makes sense. Like, it gets to the point, they know where the land is. I've given them the plots, I've given them pictures. I even took a picture of the land registry blueprint as well. But yeah, I'm intending to send that over now. I'm gonna press send. It's done, it's gone. And I'm hoping that they're gonna get back to me in due course. And I'm crossing my fingers that they have no plans with that land. There's nothing underneath it that they need to have access to that would restrict them from selling it to me. Basically, I hope that they sell it to me for a really reasonable price. Ava told us that he was able to buy his in 2014, so bearing in mind that is nearly 10 years ago, for £250. That would be a delight, but you know, inflation is probably going to be about £4,000 at this stage. But yeah, that's my hope. Anyway, I'm getting the ball rolling with that, and just cross your fingers for us, guys, because if we could claim back that small square of land, our garden would feel a lot bigger, but also I'd be able to have my dream shed out there. Like, we've got so much garden furniture and all of our gardening tools and stuff. I don't necessarily want them in the garage. I kind of want the garage to be a place where we keep all of our tools for the house, a space to be able to work in there if we need to, be able to keep things like bikes and all that stuff. But yeah, so if we were able to get that little bit of land, we could have a really good sized shed and not have to worry about storage for the garden furniture in the winter. I've had that in my mind for ages, so I'm so glad that I've done that. I can now tick that off my list. Where is it? Email. And yeah, I've still got quite a lot of things doing on here. I'm ahead of my schedule though. I gave myself until 4 o'clock to get those last few emails done, and I've got a little while. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to ring the asbestos people. Well, I'm going to do some research into asbestos because we've had one quote, but I do kind of want to get a couple more quotes just to make sure that we've got the right sort of we've got a good price and the right sort of thing that we want done. Like, I also want to make sure that they have good reviews, they get done what we need to get done, they're going to test thoroughly. I want to kind of like deep dive into all of their testing methods because I feel a little bit like I need to know what they're doing so that I can fully trust the results when they come back. And yeah, that's it. I'm just working basically.
for us to survey, say, like a five-bedroom house, a management survey, I would be charging somewhere in the region of about £500 plus VAT.
Okay.
And that would include the cost of all samples and the production of a report.
Just so that you've got a bit of background on the house, it was built in 1987. It has it's got Artex ceilings. They are all the same in all the rooms, but I would want all of the ceilings sampled.
You wanted done that, okay.
Yeah.
If I've only got to come and sample Artex ceilings and I haven't got to survey the house, you're going to be looking at about £250-300.
Okay.
Asbestos insulation board, which is a licensed material, that was banned in 1985. So you shouldn't have any insulation. You might have asbestos floor tiles. So if you lifted a carpet and you see 9-inch tiles, they're probably asbestos. But other than that, the walls would probably be solid in a plasterboard or plasterboard, and then apart from the garage and the soffits, there's not much left. Do you get what I mean?
What's a soffit?
A soffit is on the roof.
Right, okay.
Excellent. Thank you.
Perfect.
Soon.
Speak soon. Bye.
Bye.
So I've just come off the phone with a couple of the asbestos survey companies. I decided to ring round today. I want to get some quotes off of all of them, get a gauge for them and see which one we want to go with. I want to make a booking basically this week so that at the start of next week we know who we're going with. They're going to come out, sample the ceilings and sample some other stuff that they think also might contain asbestos. So it turns out it can be in floor tiles, in roof tiles, in pipes, like your pipes outside that catch the rainfall, toilet seats, and then obviously your Artex ceilings as well. I really want to make sure that we've covered everything because we are going to be doing a lot of DIY stuff ourselves. I just want to have peace of mind that, you know, like, I'm not worried about if we have to do some work without a mask on, or if there is some dust flying around the room or something like that. It's probably going to cost us near enough £500 ish. Maybe even a bit more, but it'll be worth it.
Let's set the tone, a bottle of red wine and pheromones. The conversation flows. Trust my senses, catch me if I fall. So done with second guessing, you seem to have it all. In loving enough for anything, emotional too soon. You got my invitation, now the rest is up to you. Kick it, rendezvous, make some time for me and you.
Hello! It's been a few days since I picked up the camera. I do apologise. I was about to sort out some storage for our under the stairs. Where's the door? This one. Currently got the door open, and this is our under stairs, how it looks. There's really not much going on there at the moment, but I don't know if you remember from a few vlogs ago, I always have to tidy this area because it gets thick of mud and dirt from outside, and then all of the shoes just like kind of pile up on there, and it looks really, really messy all the time, especially with then we start putting stuff on top of the console table, and then all of the coats pile up on the end of the banister. So I bought something that I'm really hoping is gonna change the game. This is a shoe rack. This is a shoe rack. I wanted to get the one from Habitat, or no, Argos, which is £35, but it was just not in stock anywhere, and I wanted it to come ASAP. So I actually found this one for cheaper on Amazon, although it doesn't look as good. The one from Argos looks much better, but I'm hoping that this is going to be a temporary fix. This was around about £17. I'll leave the one that I bought linked down below for you. The idea is that I'm literally going to connect it all together, hook it over the door, and then we can slide our shoes in it, and it's going to hide the shoes, keep them clean because they're not going to all be sitting on top of each other, and keep the floor clean as well.
Something in my brain wants you. I've been taking.
Why does nothing ever work? Ever. What we have.
I cannot explain to you how happy this makes me. This has worked out really, really, really well. So we've got all of our pairs of shoes here. We can put slippers, our everyday shoes, running trainers, boots, and then there's still so much room. Look, I've got 10 pairs. I think it actually takes 36 pairs. Apparently you can get 3 pairs alongside each other. I think you probably could add with a squish, like smaller shoes, but I reckon 2 on each row would work really, really well. So initially you were meant to hang it over the door with these things so that you don't have to screw it in place. I'm not gonna lie, these were a bit wobbly anyway, and they do have holes so that you can still adhere it to the door, but it would have been easier and it would have meant that you could lift this off and on, I don't know, if you needed to. It's probably a bit more renter friendly. I thought I was gonna have to send the whole thing back, to be honest, but I did manage to screw it in a way that it didn't hit this part. So obviously you can see our stairs is sloped there like that. So initially when I had it hanging over the door, it was just a little bit too high and it was hitting off of the stairs. So I've had to put it on the ground. It is putting on the ground a little bit. I probably could have gone up a smidge higher, but honestly it's really not a big deal. I'm really happy with that. Oh my god, we're finally gonna have a clean hallway. I'm buzzing. I'm gonna link that down below for you. So we've had our HelloFresh delivery for this week. I'm gonna sort it all out and put it away in the fridge, but I can't remember which recipes I ordered. Have a sneak peek. Oh my god. Okay, we've got butter chicken, baked naan with rocket salad and spring onion. Butter chicken is my favourite meal in the world. Crispy Chinese style duck tacos with plum sauce wedges and pickled radishes. Duck tacos, Chinese duck tacos. That might have to be dinner for tonight, you know. Fragrant chicken coconut curry. Oh, I love their curries, they're so good. And then I think I got like a cheese side for Rob for one of the meals. Honeyed goat's cheese bruschetta. He'll like that. So you know this whole pot and pan saga, I think I spoke to you last week about the new ones that we got. Le Creuset, I don't know, I feel like so incredibly lucky. Honestly, I'm so thankful and so appreciative for this. The fact that this is my job and I get to do this is crazy. But Le Creuset reached out and said, we would love to send you one of our, what one is this? This is one of their enameled cast iron pans, and I picked it in a really different color for me. Like, I was this close to choosing one of the beige ones or the all black ones. I don't know what it was, but this is one of their new styles and it's called Shell Pink, and I had to get it. I think Easter is rubbing off on me a little bit, all the pastel colors, the pinks and stuff. But yeah, they sent this out because they said we'd like love you to try one of them, and obviously if I like it, I can share. But I thought I'd share anyway because I know you guys were telling me Le Creuset, if you want them to last a lifetime you need to go Le Creuset, especially cast iron pans. So I feel so incredibly lucky, I really, really do. So thank you so much, Le Creuset. I will use this in probably an upcoming vlog and let you know how I get on with it. Probably going to be a bit of a learning curve trying to learn how to use like new types of pans that I've never used before. Literally growing up, all I've pretty much used for frying pans is like non-stick ones. But yeah, I thought I'd share that. I'll leave this link down below as well, just in case you like the look of that. I think it's a new range they've brought out, and they also had like a teal blue one, if I'm not mistaken. Oh, I don't know if that was the new one. They have 2 new ones out. Might try it tonight when we're doing the duck. Who knows? The world is my oyster. I've just been to Aldi and done a food shop. I wanted to recreate and try a tuna cardo. A tuna cardo, if you don't know, is something that Joe and the Juice make, and it is a panini style, flatbread style sort of thing, sandwich with like a tuna mousse inside, avocado, tomato, and just the nicest flavouring ever. Oh, and pesto, that's why it tastes so good. But I had it last week when I was in London, and I literally cannot stop thinking about it. So I thought I'd grab some of the ingredients to try and make it for my lunch today, just as a quick lunch. So yeah, I'm gonna try and do that. Also, they seem to have really amazing flowers on at the moment for Mother's Day. I like Aldi's flowers, they're really good. So I picked up their little magazine. I'm gonna go have a cup of tea and read this. Such a grandma. I love it though. I've just made my own version of a tuna cardo. It's basically got toasted flatbread, a layer of pesto, avocado, a tuna mousse, which has got different ingredients in, a layer of tomato, pesto, and then the flatbread. I mean, it doesn't look as good as the Joe and the Juice one. Obviously, it's homemade. It's not going to look exactly the same. And I don't have chives in it, which I definitely need, but they didn't have any in Aldi. But I thought I'd do a taste test. I'm so excited. I hope that the bread actually cracks. Oh my god. That pesto and tuna combination is insane. Oh my god. Compared to the Joe and the Juice one, I'm gonna honestly, not just because it's me, I'm gonna give this an 8 out of 10. Like, I threw my heart and soul into this and it tastes so good. This is gonna become like one of my most had lunches ever. I deep fried the flatbread in some olive oil in the pan. I think next time I might just toast it to make it a bit healthier, but this is quite a healthy lunch, to be honest. Oh, I'm buzzing. Okay, I'm gonna eat this and I'm watching the latest episode of Married at First Sight because apparently I watch crap TV. I almost feel embarrassed to come on here. I'm really sorry that I haven't posted for like, I think it was 17 days, my YouTube says. I'm so sorry, I'm so sorry, I'm so sorry. This video that you've just watched has just been a course of random clips over the last couple of weeks that I've just kind of done together. So I hope that you enjoyed the video. I thought I'd come and do an outro because honestly, I've had no structure to my videos filming. But in really good news, yesterday I painted the living room. If you follow me over on Instagram, which you should be doing, then you will have seen that. And yeah, I got it all done in a day and I'm literally obsessed with it. So I have filmed all of that. I'm literally, how many times can I say literally? I'm literally gonna go and edit the next video so that there's no long wait time for you guys. But if I'm being honest, I was in a bit of a slump. I didn't feel like what I had was good enough to put out. Really and truly, I know better than that. So I'm really sorry that you had to wait this long for a video. Thank you so much for holding out and waiting though. And thank you for the words of encouragement, the random comments on my Instagram pictures and stories, like, Shaz, where's the video? We're waiting for the vlogs. Where's the next vlog? When's it coming out? Thank you for holding me accountable. Here we are, we made it finally. Yeah, so I thought I would just outro the video, get you excited for the next one because it's gonna be a good one. And we've thrown ourselves into the makeovers now. There's no more excuses. We've finally done the first thing, really. Like, we've finally made the first steps for the first makeover in the house. And it's a pretty big one. Small changes, big impact, which is what I love. So yeah, make sure that you subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss the next video. And I feel like you can tell by my face like how happy I am about this whole thing. Like, honestly, I've woken up with such a buzz the last couple of days about the house, and now that I've done the first thing, I feel like this is it. This is it. This is the start of the content we were waiting to see. You and me both, because me too, I've been sitting here like, honey, when's it happening? Not just you, I've been waiting on me too, trust me. But yeah, I finally feel like I've had a big kick up the backside, and yeah, as I said, small changes but big impact. And yeah, that's it from me. I will see you in the next one. Take care of yourselves. And actually, if you want to, you can just head over to my Instagram because I'm about to post some pictures of the final product, but you will see the whole makeover process in the next few days. Thanks for watching. Love you lots. Bye. Mwah.